Good morning, stamping friends. Thank you for joining me today. Well, it's another hot and kind of humid day here in Arizona, but that's okay. That just means I get more time in my stamp room, so I'm okay with that. I have a lot ahead of me that I need to be working on, so all it takes is a little hot day to keep me in my room working. Well, in case you're new to my Facebook page or my YouTube channel, let me introduce myself. My name is Lori Heiling, and I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, and I've been doing this about 15 years now, and I love what I do. About a year ago, I started doing videos every Tuesday and Friday mornings. I really enjoy sharing my projects, and sometimes you just don't get the gist of everything in a still picture. So I thought I'd give videos a try. Plus, COVID kind of sent many of us into video land. So anyway, and I'm always on at 9 a.m. Arizona time. Now, some people ask me, why do you always call it Arizona time? And the reason is because we do not observe daylight savings time here. So different times of the year, our times are different. In other words, sometimes we're on Pacific Standard Time and sometimes we're on Mountain Standard Time. So that's why it's just easier to say Arizona time. Just Google what time is it in Arizona and then you'll know, 9 o'clock a.m. So I'm really excited to kick off my July class to go today. This has been a fun summer bundle to work with. Can you guess which one I'm using? And I think you're really going to fall in love, especially with the colors that's in the Designer Series paper. So however, this class I'm only going to keep open for a little over a week. That's about how long I've discovered that it takes for people to decide if they want to do it or not, rather than have it open for 2 or 3 weeks. And it just takes so long to get all your products and the PDF and the projects. So the deadline is going to be August 20th. And however, I will order your products immediately, and they are going to ship from Stampin' Up! Immediately. And then the last of the week of the month, I will get the make and takes done for you, and then you'll also get the PDF tutorial for all of the projects. So I'm going to today share a project with you that actually uses the bundle that I'm showcasing in my class to go, and then that way you'll have just another project that you can go back and watch the video and make another fun things or fun thing. And then also you might notice I like to do themed gifts, and so this is another gift type thing, and so this little project that we're going to make today would be an easy thing to tuck in with the class to go that we'll be making. So all right, let's get started. Well, let me share with you the class to go that I'm kicking off today. This one is called Sweet as a Peach, and this has been so much fun to work with this bundle. Oh, it's just gorgeous, and it's almost like you have to see it in person to see how nice and bright these colors are. So what you're going to get in this class is, let me grab the catalog quick. I opened it to page 60 and 61. Here's the complete suite here. And in this class, you will be getting the bundle, which is the stamp set, Sweet as a Peach, and also these dies down here. And these are just really peachy. So you are going to receive 5 make and takes in this one. And the class to go fee will be $70. And here's everything that you will receive. You'll get, as I said, the Sweet as a Peach bundle, the You're a Peach Designer Series paper, the Pale Papaya and White Ribbon. Let me grab that for you. It's really pretty. It's about a half inch wide. Yep. And then 5 in make and takes, and then the PDF instructions emailed to you. And the RSVP deadline for this class is July 20th. So I will post the link. And in case you already have this bundle, but you still want to get in on all these make and takes, all you have to do is substitute another product or a group of products that is $36.75 or more, and then you can still get in on this class to go class. Now, if you decide to do that, don't pay through the Constant Contact link that I'll have. Why don't you just email me, and then I will send you a new invoice. That way, if it goes over a little bit, then I can just give you the new balance. And my email address is loriheiling@gmail.com, and my name is spelled loriheiling@gmail.com. All right, and so today I want to showcase a project for you. And I don't know about you, but I like to do themed gifts a lot. And so this is something that you could add on to the bundle that I just showed you, or the class to go. And that way, you know, the way you package it could just make a gift in itself. So what I did was I found peach candy. This is called Peach Rings. They were actually out at my grocery store. Oops, oh, here we go. Gold Emblem is the brand. So I had to go to a drugstore and they had a lot of these. And of course, stampers like us like to have things coordinate. So they smell really yummy. And then the packaging that we're going to use today, these are our gusseted bags. They're 3 inches by 9 inches, and they're printed with just a really cute print that really can go with anything. And you get 25 in a bag. And so I'm going to put the project in here, and I just dumped them in here, and I'm going to set it aside. And we're just going to make a cute little tag to go with this. So I started out with basic white cardstock, and this is die cut using the layering circles dies, and it's not quite 2 3/4 inches. And I wanted this to be just kind of a basic one. I don't want to make it too fancy. Sweet and simple is sometimes better. And then I'm using Balmy Blue, which is a coordinating color with the Designer Series paper. It just really looks great with the peaches and the oranges that are in the DSP. So we're just going to take a blending brush. And when you use blending brushes, less is more. That's the rule, okay? So don't go too dark for what we're going to do here. And we're just going to put a little bit in the center of the circle. And we just want to kind of offset that peach that is going to be on top of this. So like I said, less is more. In fact, you may not even see it on the camera, but I can see it starting to blend in a little bit here. So that's how we're going to start. Now, when we do the peach, I want to show you a couple different ways that you can shade this. So let's set this aside now. And I played around with so many different colors when I was using this stamp set, and I came up with my favorite is Mango Melody, but you can also use Pale Papaya or Calypso Coral, and I'll show you the reason I like this one. So I'm just going to take the peach stamp, and you're going to want to use the little mat. They're double this size. I just cut mine down because I don't need such a big one. So I'm going to first stamp this one. And remember, when you use photopolymer, you want to use this mat, because in our red rubber stamps, the foam, I call it the gush, is already in the stamp. But because this is just the photopolymer, you need that gush that will help it sink in. And so that's why we use the mat. So what I did was just stamp this, and then you're going to take a dauber and the color Calypso Coral. And what I do is I just put a tiny bit on the end, and I kind of make sure there's not too much. I kind of rub most of it off. And then I'm just going to go in on the shaded side and make it a little bit darker, and it'll just pull some of that, the oranges in. And you'll see that it matches our candy even a little bit better, because that's pretty dark there. Now, there is one other way that I found. We're going to ink it again with Mango Melody, but this time, instead of inking it on the paper, we're going to ink it on the stamp. And so just lightly kind of dauber it here, and then you just stamp it, and it'll kind of have the blending already done. Not quite as dark. I prefer this way because I can keep adding a little bit more, and even if you want to go on this side a little bit, you can. But this one, you can see it's a little bit darker there, but not as much. And then, so I just wanted to show you a couple different techniques like that. All right, now let's get to the tag that we're going to make for this little candy treat. So throw that to the side, and here's a done one with the shading. And I think I better keep my paper here just in case. All right, so when I make a tag, I first like to position it where I think everything will go. So I wanted the peach to go about here. And you know what I love about this die set is that there is a cute little branch. Isn't that great? We used to have a larger one in a different die set that is retired, but I was so excited when they brought this, because you can use this for so many things other than just peach things. So what I'm gonna do is kind of put it at an angle, but like I said, I wanna kind of set it up first before I start gluing down. All right, and the reason I'm kind of playing with it is because I want to make sure my sentiment fits on here. So I'm gonna grab the Calypso Coral again. And the stamp I want to use is called Sweet as a Peach, and we're just going to go in with this, and it doesn't really matter if it isn't straight, because we can adjust the peach after, because it's on a circle. All right, I think this looks pretty good here, so I'm going to line up to make sure my words are going the right way. All right, let's glue that little branch down, And I think Tombow works great for this because all we're gonna do is put a few dots on the back. As soon as I get, I just usually have to pull the little hunk off at the top, the dry stuff, and then usually gets going. But sometimes I have a pin handy just to poke in there. All right, now I put a little bit much on there. I can't even grab anything here. We'll make it come down about right here. All right, now you can go ahead and put your peach on. And of course, we like to always use dimensionals on things. So let's add a couple dimensionals, but don't go too far over the edge because we might hang it over the edge of the circle a little bit. Just have that line up again. Right at the top. All right, now we need to add some leaves, and look at all the leaves that are cut from that one die set. I only cut one out of all of the tiny little leaves, and that's how many you get. There's two that are two together, and then you get four of these. So you can cut out quite a few of these, and I'm gonna use my pick tool because these are sometimes hard to pick up. All right, so let's go by putting, we know we want one for sure, like on the peach, because most of these, I had to Google, what does a peach look like on the tree? Like, where are all these leaves placed? Oh boy. Have you ever gone peach picking? I have not. I'm not a huge peach fruit lover, but I have had really sweet and soft ones. Those I like, but in Arizona, I don't know. It seems like we don't really get those big juicy ones. I bet they're in Georgia. I know I call my grandkids that live there Georgia peaches. So of course I had to get this set. All right, let's put some more. Wherever you see the end of a branch, let's add some there. And maybe it'll be easier to put it on the paper rather than on those tiny little leaves. Whoopsie. And then you drop them on the ground. All right, let's see, let's add. One here. And another one here. Actually, let's go upside down for this one so it's going in a different direction. And since I have an extra one, let's just put one more over here. There we go. All right, now the only last thing that we need to do is punch a hole in here, and let's see if I can grab. This one will need a little bit wider hole because the ribbon that we're going to use is the pale papaya, which is in the bundle for the class to go that I'm offering. All right, how do you guys store your ribbon? I should show you sometime. Maybe I can take a still, but my husband made my ribbon holder. I absolutely love it. It's just made out of rain gutter from Home Depot. And then he covered it with fabric that matches in my craft room. And then I just put all my ribbon on there. And then at USA, I stuck a little pin on the end because I do not like all those ends, you know, kind of unrolling on the shelf. So that's how I store mine. I remember, I'll snap a photo so you can see. All right, so let's just tie this in a nice little bow. And then again, remember you have to make the hole bigger than normal because this is pretty wide ribbon. And then let's just tie it one more time. And then we'll tie it in a bow. And voila, you can kind of putz with the bow, but let me trim this off quick. And I usually try to make these about the same distance for how long they are. And the last thing is, if you don't like a big top, just trim that down a little bit. I'm just going to leave it large because I think it looks all right. But there you go. Isn't that a sweet little tag? Sweet as a peach. So this will go in my collection of the card case that I have. Actually, I'm going to show you the front of it because it's hard to see. You're going to get four cards plus this cute little acetate box with a belly band around with another little tag here. And then there's four cards and four envelopes. The envelopes have the DSP on the flap, so they're all coordinated. But anyway, that's what you're gonna get in the class to go. Well, thank you so much for joining me today. And I hope to see you at the end of the week, and I'll share more projects with you. And then be sure to sign up on the link that I will post. And thank you so much, everyone. See you next time. Bye-bye.